You can see here are the different folders. So among them, you can select this one. So we can select our genes for qPCR through this list. You can see. Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will tell you how we can select our genes for qPCR validation from transcriptomic data. Actually, the DEG selection for qPCR can be done in two ways. The first way is that we can select our top, up and down regulated DEGs, and the second way is that we can select those genes which are related to your phenotype. So now we will discuss one by one that how we can select our top, up and down regulated DEGs and how we can select our genes related to our phenotype. So in the first way, how we can select top, up and down regulated DEGs. In the first step, you have to check your all transcriptomic data folders and you need to scroll out that where are our DEGs list. There would be many DEGs list, but we have to find that DEGs list which show usually the significant DEGs. In the second step, we have to filter all the genes in DEGs FC value in descending order. And in the third step, we have to select our top 10 to 30 genes and we need to design primer for qPCR validation. So let me show you by one example that how we can select our top, down and up regulated DEGs from transcriptomic data folders. So here is actually my rna-seq data which was sent to me by a company. So you can go to result folder. You can see here are the different folders. So among them you can select this folder which shows the differentially expressed genes. Here you can see here are the different list and here is actually that list which we require. You can see here I have two treatments. One is the mutant type and the second one was the wild type. It shows the differentially expressed genes at the p-value less than 0.05 and the FC value greater than 2. So what we have to do, as we previously discussed, first of all, we can open this list and we can try to figure out where is the log 2FC value. Here you can see the column F is actually showing the log FC value. So what we have to do, we have to filter this column in ascending or descending order. So what we can go to this data tab. We can select on this filter. You can see here now filter is appeared. You can click on this small dot. It will show you that how you want to sort. So if we want to sort it from largest to smallest, you can click on this. You can see here all the genes have been sorted out. And here you can see here is actually showing some genes which are not actually showing DEGs more than 2. So we don't need to consider them. And here it is showing inferior. We also don't need to consider them. So here are those genes which are showing the FC value in positive. That would be our upregulated genes. So we can select our genes for qPCR through this list. You can see this list. Let's suppose we can select our top 30 because this is 20. So if we are going to select our 30 genes, so we can go up to 350. Yeah, 350, and we can just highlight them. We can select our upregulated DEGs according to their function. So you can see and try to relate your phenotype with these genes that which like subdeletion like serine protease or which family of protein is upregulated in your phenotype. So among this all 30 genes, we can select any 5 or 10 genes and we can validate them through qPCR. So this was actually the upregulated DEGs. So similarly, we can go to at the end and select down-regulated DEGs. So here you can, we know that F folder was showing the FC value. So we can select, let's suppose 10 or 20 genes. If we select only 10 genes, so we can select these genes and using their annotation data, we can select out of all these 10, we can select any 5 or even 10 for qPCR validation. So this is the first way to select our genes for qPCR analysis. Let's go back and try to find that what is the second way to select qPCR. In the second way, we can select those genes which are related to your phenotype. And how we can select those genes which are related to our phenotype? In the first step, we have to think that how our phenotype under study is different from the control. And in the second step, we have to associate your phenotypic and biochemical analysis with pathways through literature. And in the third step, we have to explore the significant DEGs list and find that pathway genes. Let me show you through this example, one of my research article. I can show you here, I have actually characterized two mutants and I have done transcriptomic analysis of them. Here you can see my wild type has normal anther, but my mutant type has degenerated anther. So actually I have done transcriptomic analysis and I have also done some biochemical and phenotypic analysis. You can see my biochemical analysis is telling that overall VAX and cutin in the mutant type is significantly decreased compared to the wild type. So it means we can also select those genes which are related to VAX and cutin for qPCR validation. So what we can do, similarly, we can go into this list and we can select those genes which are related to VAX and cutin and they have been reported in the literature. So here you can see in while citing my transcriptomic data, I have used the validation of those genes which were related to the VAX and cutin. Here I have given that validation data in supplementary file and here I have downloaded that supplementary file. You can see here I have selected 5 upregulated and 5 downregulated DEGs from that list and I have used them for transcriptomic data validation. So the similarly, you can also select your genes for qPCR validation. So hopefully in this way, you can select genes for qPCR validation from your transcriptomic data. But if you have still any question or any confusion, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.